Hello, Waterbuck. This is our first encounter within the park, and it's within the Rhino Sanctuary to our right. A nice waterbuck harem. We have Elsa's copia in the background, right over the sanctuary. It's a long way from here. White-browed sparrow weaver building her nest, or building his nest, since in this case it is the males who come up with the nests. So after this, any prospecting female will come and inspect the nest. If he finds it good, he will jump in and lay her eggs in this beautiful nest. If not, she will cut it off the tree and it will fall down, and the male has to start afresh and build another nest. So as he continues to build, he also calls out for potential mates, any females around, and most likely he hears no answer and just waits. Soap up, starling. Two of the lovely soap up starlings here. So the guinea fowl has sensed our presence and is now frozen, won't move anymore, just observing us. On the other hand, this is a yellow-necked sparrowfowl. The guinea fowl is one of their cousins. So I mistook him for his cousin. The grass is currently very high, so he's having trouble going through it. So there we have one of the shrikes. We'd have to have a closer look to know exactly which shrike it is, because we have several. So he has found a mate. This is a long-tailed fisco shrike. The long-tailed fisco. I think they are having a mating dance, singing their hearts out for the ladies. On the other hand, we have the white-headed buffalo weaver. So we now have a double white-headed buffalo weaver. So now we have a presentation of our lovely looking ostriches. And of course we know here in Meru we have the Somali ostrich, the guy in blue on the left side of the picture. Majestically walking through the grass and perhaps onto the road and across it. The lady says, "Come on, darling, I cannot leave you behind, so let's go across together, like we always have. Please come, come this way." So you went to the laundry and had everything washed. You pick up your jackets and you forget the trousers. Very, very strange. Should have been the other way around. Forget the jacket, pick up the trousers. So from the back side we have our first elephant encounter. This is a relatively big male with short tusks, little tusks. Thank you. Now we see clearly who you are. This is on the left side of the road, the Morera side, the Morera River side. And this is a good sign that there's more of them. And there he goes into the bush, and we have no choice but to let him be. Come on, starling, don't be afraid. We are on a regular inspection mission, so relax. So that's how it looks like back towards the Nyambene Hills. He's got some flies on his stomach, or tempting the other male to a fight. Just found out this guy is having lots of problems with insects. I don't know whether it is a sese or any other insect, but he's shaking his legs and fighting the grass. He's in trouble. So this one won't move off the road. From the dirt on his body, You can tell he's had a few misadventures. Amongst the normal zebras here, we have one Grevy just behind them, and of course with the Elsas in the background. We associate the Grevys more with the Elsas area, but this time round, here they are on the Muleka Plains. Eland as well, so here we have plenty of game to see. Sorry. So we have another elephant on the prowl, walking and grazing around and not wanting us to pass by. one of the best gathering of oryx we have seen in a while. This is just off number one. Just like we saw with the impala last evening, the one that was having trouble with the flies, it is somewhat similar with the oryx. They're having to fight a lot of flies in the air. Good morning, Mr. Go Away Bird. This is one of the commonly seen turacos. Very, very vocal. We have here some golden-backed weavers. Golden-backed weavers. A beautiful buffalo, but very anxious. I think this guy is in attack mode. You don't want to mess with him. You don't want to cross his path. Alright, here we have a group of crested francolins. They have been running away from us, escaping our view, but now we have them in full clear view. Crested francolin. So we've got two hornbills staring at us. It's a very, very quiet day today. Not much sunshine anyway, and definitely very, very little wind. Another harem of very nervous impala. They look very, very wary, as if afraid something might spring out of the bushes. So here we have still in the Boaterongi swamp. This is the saddle-billed stork, Sattelstork. He's hiding away from us, obviously not knowing that we can see his position. So he finally gives up and moves on. A palm tree seemingly growing out of the other tree. It's magic, magic, magic. So here we have our first giraffe, the reticulated giraffe, and I have just noticed a pride of lions. That's what he's looking at to the left side of the road. Okay, let's observe the lions. So right under this tree, small tree in the picture, in the middle of the picture, we will zoom in on the cuts. And there they are, going back to sleep. So I notice we have about 5 of them. 3 are sound asleep, so we'll have another moment to check if we have more of them. We had another one just crossed the road in front of us. We missed out on her while concentrating on the others. So she will go to them and find out what's been happening or what has not been happening. How are you? So I think we were right, these are 5 sisters, I think. And we have another 2 further on the left side. So that makes about 7. So then we have 6 lionesses here, all looking out maybe towards the giraffe, see if there is a possibility for having an early lunch, while the other 2 are still relaxed. This is one of the lead females. The more mature looking one. So she decides maybe they can try later. But her sister decides maybe it's worth a little more investigation. This lady may not be so hungry, but her sister was, because she has a fuller belly here. And the lazier ones don't want to get up. They will get up only if they are assured of a good meal, but for now the chances are 50-50. Surveying the area.
Como para les idea, ¿eh?
She's got on her nose, both sides of the nose, several dark dots, which are very distinct, and they point her out from the rest. Hunger, hungry. So now she moves on, she moves around the car. So I guess the idea is now to return to the rest of the gang, especially the ones that are under that small bush to the left there. So that makes four on this small bush. Yes, they rise up to welcome their sisters and friends, but they go by probably going to look for a place of her own, away from the rest of them. Is that a good place, maybe? No, she moves on. This one decides to join her sisters. Probably going to the bigger tree there, the bigger bush, with more shade. I think it's a good decision since it's not too far away from the rest, and she can have more room. Yes, that's where she's going. And the other sister comes along as well, but goes to the smaller one. So here we see a giraffe bump scrubbing its backside against the bush. So here we have Impala Bachelors, that's the Bachelors Club or Boys Club. So we have in the distance a Cory Bustard in breeding mode, raising up the tail to the back of the head and inflating the neck. So we come back to the lioness that approached the big tree, and here she is, enjoying the time of her life. So these are the elands walking away as usual from us. And the big gray male. He's nervous, very, very nervous, but he should not worry. We are not lions. We are Paul and Martin. We are all entitled to some play, so this is her moment. This is Papa. This is his moment to enjoy some good play. Thank you. Hello, Mr. Bastard. Over, can I lap wing? Crested plover. So come on, Mr. Crown Plover. Are you interested in a game with us? Come play. As we drive back towards the Elsass area, we come back across the same lions from this morning, still trying to make up a plan. They are very hungry, that was clear. So we will now go as far as Elsass and leave them alone for a while until on our way back, if we can find them again. Okay.
Okay.
this is an impala with some rather strange horn formation, and very long for that matter. So we compare the two sets of horns together. The strange guy on the right walking away. The other one is a pretty normal guy. Normal horn formation. So finally, as we arrive at Elsa's, here is one of the big jumbos. Although he has his back turned to us, he's quite big. Tusks, fairly good. So as we now enter Mugwango Swamp proper, this is our first greeting. So as you drive towards Mugwango, this is the situation in the sky. The clouds or the sky heavily pregnant with rain clouds. Should be coming down in about 1 hour's time. Thank you. Looks like she's injured. The lady Gerenuk is limping. So here comes Papa Gerenuk. Or maybe, yes, a younger male. Trying to find out what's happening with the lady. Looks like we have a varan in the water. It's a monitor lizard or something like that. Let's see. Come on out, we are okay, we are no danger to you. It's a varan. He majestically walks out of the water. And onto dry land. Feeling good. So here's the Cory bustard in full mating display, trying to attract mates. So it's time to wake up lions. Find out if you are interested in an evening meal. If you are, then it's time to start moving. This little guy is chewing on something. So I think they managed to catch something small, but that was not satisfying. They are still hungry, so. This is a gathering of young or relatively young ostrich, those that have probably grown up together and have just matured together. We have here an army of impalas patrolling the area. Maybe they are the new rangers doing the rounds. Well, it's been raining and nobody wants to get into the warm grass or into the cold grass and the wet grass, so they all prefer to be on the road. On the left side of the highway, we have the group of elands. This is on the Murera side. These are more eland than we have seen in a couple of months.
They are big.
This again are the long-tailed fisco. It's a shrike. Two black with blacksmith's plover. So alongside the river, we have a pied kingfisher, one of the biggest. We are now at the junction between Mutondo and Makutano rivers. It's Mutondo and Rojawero rivers. This is where they meet. So from the right side of the picture comes the Rojawero, and from under the picture flows the Mutondo River. They both have lots of water. This is the Rojawero. And ahead of us, we have a spillover of the Mutondo, less water than on the main bridge. This is Mutondo spillover, and at that point, most of the water goes to the left under the main bridge, and here we have a spillover. So that's one of the desert roses in the thicket. See the flowers. Hello, Mr. Elephant. Nice to see you. Here, Mokomeva. Here, Hina. Here, Kamukwani. As we drive into the Mururi swamp, we come across one bull elephant here. Short tusks or otherwise broken. Just browsing in the trees and relaxing.
Thank you.
Good morning, here we are on the next drive for the day, and on this Mulika circuit we find a couple of vultures on the ground. They are up to something. Smells like something that's been dead for quite some time. So what have you been up to this morning, Mr. Vulture? So that's it. A dead buffalo. So up the tree we see the rest of the vultures waiting for us to move away so they can join in the party. So this is somewhere along the Murera circuit, on the Murera side of the main highway, and we have two young bulls. running away as always. So here we have a black-bellied bustard, the Mulika airstrip wind van, and Elsa's way in the background. Spatial combination.
Naweza chukua pamoja na zile nyabai na hiyo ve.
So for the grand gazelles, we've only seen a couple of them over the last few days. So here is a good presentation. So this guy is still looking for mate, but still generally in the same area. I wonder why he doesn't search further out. But this is truly an impressive display. The tail curled up all the way backwards to the back of the head. There it goes up again. Beautiful. And for the first time at the Rojavero Bridge, we come across an African darter, or the so-called Schlangenvogel. There's our impala with the funny looking horns, staring at us from a distance.
years
later. So there's his bodyguard. Mist of buffalo, why the stern face? So today, in place of the varan, we have the hammerkop and a plover hanging about this water. Yesterday was a varan enjoying a swim.
Oink. Kaulia gari. Oink. Oink.
just noticed that they are both two young males. There could be more in the bushes, but this looks like the older of the boys. So he's going to try and bring down a buffalo. We have 1.5 million buffaloes in the bushes, not far from there, maybe 50, 60 meters. I wonder why the other brother is not coming. So this one decides to go all alone. So from our position, you can see the buffalo falling into a panic. They just ran away, and the lion strategizes with his mouth open. Together with his brother, and they're happy to be so. Thank you. So the young guys have decided to take a break. It's a long walk for them. And maybe they'll go for the buffaloes later in the evening. And here is the other brother with the shorter hair. So these are some vultures which probably know there is a gang of lions on the prowl, and as usual waiting for some prey to come down. Wish them well. This is the Roger Wero having lots of water. Hello, Mr. Goliath Heron. You sincerely hope we cannot see you, but we saw you this morning. Egyptian vulture in flight. So here in the dry tree, I think we have a brown snake eagle. Yes, that's a brown snake eagle. Not the ideal of places. It's up in the tree against the light, but identifiable.
ni faina itatokezea kwa ile ni corridor.
Very nervous shakal. I think he has some business over here, but he wants us to leave. And a vulture, white-backed vultures, at the site where we had buffalo, dead buffalo yesterday. Sparrow weaver. This is a special early morning array for giraffes. Quite relaxed. Thank you. He's now headed for the bushes next to that big tree where he will be out of view for the moment. And that's how it is with lots of flies and small butterflies.